Hi, my name is Robert from themeisle.com, and in this tutorial I will show you how to set up Shopisle Pro WordPress theme so that you sell your products wisely with your online store. Until the end of this video, you'll know how to create every section, step by step, starting with the modern and responsive fullscreen slider, and continuing with the main menu, then scrolling down through every section to the footer area. You'll see how I create the blog section with some demo content with images and text. Use this for your content marketing strategy and write compelling articles about your products. Google will love that. Moreover, you will discover how easy it is to activate this helpful quick view button that appears below the add to cart button on hovering over the image. This button will open the product's details in a lightbox without leaving the current page. Notice that you can jump right to your preferred section of this video using the carefully created timestamps in the description below. Let's start with the theme installation. Head to Appearance, Themes in your WordPress dashboard, then click Add New. Upload the theme archive, then click Install Now. After the installation is complete, activate the theme, then enter your license key in the Settings section. You'll find it in the purchase history from your themeisle.com account. The next step is about WooCommerce, the most popular e-commerce platform on the web. If you want to watch a step-by-step tutorial about WooCommerce, click on the suggested video in the right top corner. After you install WooCommerce, follow the instructions to publish more products, then go back to the theme customizer. I have 4 published products that we will use in this tutorial, complete with a short and full description, price and discount, category, tags, product image and a gallery with more images. If the homepage does not display anything like the demo, don't worry. I'll show you how to do it immediately. Add a new page with a title like Home or Front. Leave it empty and select the front page template from the drop-down list. Then hit Publish. Now, go to Static Front Page section in your customizer, then tick a static page to be your front page. Select the name of your new page from the drop-down list, then click to save and publish your settings. Let's continue this tutorial with an important step, the site identity. It's actually very easy to do it using a 300 pixels wide and 90 pixels tall custom logo, a compelling title and subtitle, then finish by uploading a custom site icon. Save and publish. The Colors section is where you can change the default color scheme to your preferred one, using the options from the drop-down, or by selecting the colors through the color picker for the header, background, navbar background, menu items on hover and footer background. If you wish to revert the color back to its original state, just hit the clear button near the hex value. The header image uploaded here will be displayed on every single page, including the blog page. Set a custom image here according to your field of activity and the suggested dimensions. Let's start customizing the front page sections. I would like to mention that you can change the position of a section anytime with drag and drop. This is how you'll move the services section under the slider section as in the demo. Here is the full screen image slider section, and we can change everything with our own content. Click on the existing slide to reveal options that are inside, then upload a new full HD image. Change the title and subtitle using the text fields. Set a button link and type a button label, then open the next slide and do the same. If you plan to display more than 3 slides, just click on the Add New Field button below. Notice that you can replace the homepage slider with any plugin you like. Just copy the shortcode generated and paste it here. Remember to hit Save and Publish when you are done. Here are 3 active banners for this section, and you can change the image within by uploading a new one. Type a custom link in the button link field, do the same for every banner you use, add a new field if you wish, and move to the next step. Now click on Products section. Here is the section that helps you display some published products on the front page. Be sure that the Hide Products section is unchecked. Type a title, then choose the category of products to be displayed. You may notice one more field named WooCommerce Shortcode. Paste your WooCommerce shortcode here to display a custom selection of your products. Save and publish. Use a video from your YouTube channel to promote a new product in this section as background. Type a title, then paste your YouTube video link here and set a custom video thumbnail if needed. Choose the padding of this section from 130 to 400 pixels. Save the settings, then move to the next section. The ribbon section is where we can add a full width background image under a custom text and a call to action button. Set the link for the button and you are done. This is actually the first section in our demo, when you start scrolling down. And you can drag it there like this. Now click to edit the section, set a title, a subtitle, then edit the content from every service box. Add a new service box if needed, then save your work. A second section that can display some products on the front page as a slider is this. Tick if you wish to hide this section, and do the same to hide it on a single product page. In order to have a usable shortcode for this section, you need to install and activate the InterGeo WordPress Google Maps plugin. After the installation is complete, go to the InterGeo Maps options in your WordPress dashboard settings. Click to add a new map, then drag and zoom the center of the map to your location. Click to create the map, then copy the generated shortcode and paste it in the map section of your theme customizer. You have a full screen map that shows the location of your business on the front page now. This is a special section that can help you promote popular categories of your products, but you need some time to see products here. Use this section to display an email sign-up form, for example, or use it for any other shortcode that can display content in a custom style. The footer section of your website will be visible on every page or post, so keep in mind to populate it with the copyright information and some social media links. In the Advanced Options section, you can set a custom content for your 404 error page with a custom background image, title, text and button. Select the font size from the drop-down menu, then hit to save your work. If you wish to set a custom background image for all of your pages and posts, this section is for you. Upload your image, then set the default preset, image position, size, and tick to repeat and scroll with the page if needed. Then move to the next section. Please click to another suggested video in the right top corner of the screen to watch how easy it is to create those pages. In order to have a blog page, you need to do 2 things. First, create and publish some blog posts. And the second one is to create a new page named blog, then select blog template from the drop-down list and publish it. The blog page is ready now and you can place it in your header menu as in our demo. Finishing touches comes last, And one more step is to create the menu. Head to Menus section, then click to add a menu. Name it as you wish and click Create Menu. Tick the display location and menu options, then hit Save and Publish. Now, click to add items in that menu, then click to add as many items you want. You can use any element to create submenus by dragging it under an item to the right. Choose your preferred widgets for the footer area that will display useful information about your business, links to terms and services pages, top-rated products and more. These widgets are displayed in the footer area of your website on any page or post. Now, are you ready for the promised step? Here is how you can activate the Quick View button when hovering over the product image in your online shop. It's easy. Just install the WooCommerce Quick View plugin, then activate it. Everything looks great and works as in the demo. And your online shop is ready for more content, but more importantly, for new clients. Thanks for watching. Check out our latest tutorials about WordPress. Please share them if you like what you see. Hit the like button and ask any question through the comment section below. Help us inform you about new uploads by hitting the subscribe button right here.